Hi. My name is my name is Ashwin, and I'm a filmmaker. It took me 10 years after my college to become a filmmaker. I mean, my parents were doctors, so you can imagine, like, without any connections, I went to a lot of people. I worked in a call center, I worked in an advertising firm, I worked in an event management company. I found my way finally 10 years later, getting a chance to make my first feature film, and that was Yevade Subramanyam. So, yeah, so that was what I thought would be like essentially a finish line. You know, like after waiting for 10 years, you kind of make a film. And yeah, this these fans sound like the wind in Mount Everest, basically, when I was shooting Yevade like this. So just adding to the effect. And then after that, like, you know, once you achieve what you think is your goal, the thing with filmmaking is you make a film, and it's not like any other job where you're like, okay, you get a promotion or you get a next thing. The point is you come back to the starting again. You're back at square one, and again you have a blank piece of paper. Again you have no actors. Again you have no producers. You have to start from scratch again. And again, I started from scratch, and so then I started working on Savitri Garu's biopic. I made a film called Mahanati, which took 2 years of my life, essentially. So 2 years later, again, I reached, you know, the end of that particular journey. And again, basically, I'm back in square one, again, a blank piece of paper, again, no actors, no ideas. So basically, when I was asked to speak to you guys, I just thought maybe I will discuss what my next film would be, basically. So I thought I could talk about an idea that's been going on in my head. So, you know, what better thing to talk about? So I'll start off with a few years back, like after my first film, I was invited for a TEDx talk. Usually directors are really good behind the camera, they're not good in front. So that TEDx talk was all over the place, but the basic idea was that, you know, there were three people I was talking about, a scientist, a spiritual guru, and a neuroscientist, who all talked about, you know, how everything is one. So, you know, science and spirituality and gurus, they're all talking about, like, the interconnectedness of things. So I was saying that, you know, there's so many problems in the world. Like, you know, pollution, you're saying war, you're saying poverty. I'm saying instead of firefighting each of them, why don't we identify the cause? And I felt that the cause of all of that was because a lack of spiritual growth in people, a lack of spiritual process in society. Because, you know, back in the day, there were enlightened beings like a Buddha, a Muhammad, Jesus, and everybody who used to, you know, come out of the society and tell people that, you know, this is the path. But of course, in recent times, we don't have any of that. So that's one of the main reasons, I think, like, you know, everything is so chaotic. And so anyway, so that's basically where the idea for my next film starts. It starts with the hero, who wants to obviously make a great world and save the world, because that's what all heroes do. And then we have obviously a villain. You know, we need to have a villain. And my villain, at this point, I haven't named him, but he's essentially 4G internet, basically. 4G high-speed internet is my villain, and we have to fight him. And so where does this start, basically? So we'll just call the villain for namesake, we'll call him Subbu, like from my first film, Yevade Subramanyam, and we'll call the hero Rishi, just so that it's easy to talk about names. So Rishi wants to, you know, work on himself, you know, be happy, live in the moment and all that. You know, be a cool guy. And Subbu, on the other hand, is very hungry. Like, you know, he has this complete urge to always grow. Like, one job is not enough. The next job, the salary, what's the next salary? He has a phone, he buys another one the next month. He has a car, he's always looking outside his window at the other car that's pulled up next to him. There's no satisfaction. There's always growth, basically. And so that growth is endless. Like when you're talking in a materialistic world, what is the end of that growth? You can make 100 billion and you can always make 101 also. You can make 200, you can always make 201. So there's no growth for this. There's no end for this. So like how does, so what is the, you know, future? What is the progression of a, of our villain basically? So after he grows a certain, after he goes a certain place, any big business has to lose a little bit of its morality. And they have to grow, they have to encroach, they have to be aggressive, they have to take over your personal spaces in order to push things so that they can grow, right? So the first weapon that our villain had was this, was the television. So our villain first got hands on this television. He didn't know what it was, but when he finally figured out what it could do, in the late 60s, he realized he could inject culture. He could alter culture by advertising, by soap operas, by any sort of programming that went right into people's houses. Till then it was, you know, newspaper, there was some difference. But for the first time, our villain can enter people's bedrooms. Right, and when you're sleeping in your most private times, he can sell you toothpaste, he can sell you like whatever he wants using any means. There was no right or wrong. So, you know, for a good 30 odd years, he was happy, you know. There was growth, you know, there's always this growth, what is the next quarter results, whatever. So he's always growing, he's always growing. For 30 years, it was great, you know, till the 2000s almost. And then something happened which completely changed the game, which nobody was expecting. And that happens to be our super brahmastra for this villain, which happens to be smartphones and high-speed internet access to smartphones. So what Rishi till now is just being happy. He's thinking like, you know, I can sit under a tree, meditate, I'll go smile at people, and you know, that's how the world will become a bigger, better place. And Subbu suddenly has his hand on like, you know, he can put whatever content he wants into your smartphone. And right now, just some random figure, like from 2011 to now, like smartphone penetration in the US has gone from 30% to 95%. So just, it's literally in everybody's hand. I'm sure everybody in this room has a smartphone, right? So anyway, so basically the point is there's so much content, like, you know, good content, bad content, random content, vines, advertising, provocative images, pornography. There is just, it's just all over the place. 30% of the internet is pornography. Like, you know, like 10, 15 years back, like that, you know, you had to make an effort, you know, go find something provocative. But right now, you don't even have to. It just pops up without even asking for it on screen. Like, that's how it's become. So is this part of, like, some grander plan of Mr. Subbu? We'll find out. So this is something which I just put in the last minute. This is actually a slide from a really high funda marketing conference in New York, okay? So this is on the slide. They're literally saying, you want to be in the business of appealing to people's sex organs. So they're not even hiding this. This is in their public seminar. So every advertisement that, you know, whether you're buying a cell phone, a pair of glasses, shoes, socks, toothpaste, whatever, is sexualized today. And for a good reason, because that is the only way it, like, you know, just, you know, catches you in the loop or something, gets your attention. And And obviously, a lot of you are medical students, you know something about the reward circuit in your brain, right? Like, whenever you get something good, dopamine gets released, so it becomes an addiction. So every sort of addiction, whether it's alcohol or drug or anything, is usually connected to a dopamine addiction. So guess what? Cell phones are probably the next biggest addiction that we have. So anyway, everything is energy, right? I genuinely believe that Rishi and Subbu, they all have a certain amount of energy every day. They eat whatever food they're eating, it gets converted into the energy. And what you do with that energy is completely up to you. You can use it to work, you can use it to play sports, you can use it to question yourself. You can use it to grow your body. You can use it to grow your consciousness, your mind, whatever you want. It's that energy is yours. But what is happening is, as soon as there is Subbu's master weapon inside your pocket all the time, you almost don't have a choice of what to do with that energy anymore, because it's addictive. Your dopamine keeps going off. I need to buy this. Oh, there's a flash sale. Oh, you know, I want to check out what's happening on that person's life. There's social media. There's constantly, there's something going on that is just draining. That is just draining everybody's energy. Like, obviously, if you know, you're just going to be, you know, just happy and joyful and aware and all that, Subbu's not going to make any money out of this. He's not going to become, you know, the super villain that he's destined to be. So at this point, each of our energies are getting drained every day. And we are standing at a point where we don't completely understand this, because smartphone internet use is very recent. Like, I would say, like, in our country, not even in the States, in our country, it's as recent as 5 to 6 years old. So you need, like, how long do you need, how much data do you need to actually study addictions? Maybe a decade at least, maybe 2 decades to understand what the process is. This is too young, so nobody's really understanding, you know, like, where this is going to go. Maybe, like, 10 years down the line, somebody will actually stand back and say, this is what happened to our generation. This is what this generation could have done with this energy, but it has been, you know, sucked in. Like, it has been sucked into, you know, a non-productive way. And, yeah, this is literally, like, if you see our amazing, like, there's one grandma here. Like, she's the only one that's really clueless about what's going on. Everybody's at dinner and she's like, why is nobody talking to me? But, this is an idea. I don't know. I genuinely don't know how to make this a movie, because it's a very tricky subject. But I feel it's also probably one of the most important things that are happening in our world or in our society right now. And it's probably not as mainstream as it should be, because it's prevalent, it's everywhere. And if you think that you spending an hour on Facebook or Insta, or you just getting distracted because there's so much content out there, is not an impediment, then I think you should really just be aware and watch yourself. There's some apps on the phone, like how much you use and what you'll use. It's a lot of fun. So I think it's up to us to see what the climax of this film is going to be, because it's so early on in the game. And as soon as I figure out how to write it, I'll let you guys know. And I hope it'll work out, and I'll see you at the finish line. Thank you.